فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، الحديث الخامس، the fifth حديث، في قيام رمضان، establishing the fasting of Ramadan. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. متفق عليه. This hadith is an evidence about the virtues of one establishing Ramadan, and that it is a cause or a means for one's sins to be forgiven and his shortcomings. So if a person establishes Ramadan with Iman, and the word Iman here means what? مُصَدِّقًا بِوَعْدِ اللَّهِ وَبِفَضْلِ قِيَامِ وعظيم أجره أجره عند الله. The person fasts believing in Allah تبارك وتعالى's promises that Allah has promised, and the virtues of establishing the prayer and the virtues of establishing the fasting as it should be done, and the great reward that he would have the day of judgment. Ihtisaban means he does it, muhtasiban, athawab indallah, he does it hoping to get reward from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. La biqasdi akhara, he's not doing it for any other intention. Abu Huraira narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يرغب في قيام رمضان, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to urge, he used to encourage for the people to stand in prayer in the month of Ramadan. من غير أن يأمرهم بعزيمة. But the Prophet would not order them in a forceful manner. And the Prophet would say, مَنْ قَامَ رَمَضَانَ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرًا لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. Anyone who stands up in Ramadan with Iman and with Ihtisab, then his past sins are forgiven. It is upon every one of us, فَعَلَى الْمُسْلِمِ, it is upon each and every one of us that we strive in praying the Salatu Taraweeh with the Imam, and that we do not miss any of it inshaAllah ta'ala, and that we don't leave it before the Imam. وَلَوْ زَادَ عَلَىٰ إِحْدَى عَشَرَ رَكْعَةٍ, even if the Imam goes over 11 rak'ah, and he prays more than 11, he prays 23 rak'ah, that we don't leave it, we pray with him from the beginning to the end. Based on the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ قَامَ مَعَ الْإِمَامِ, anyone who stands up with the Imam, حَتَّى يَنْصَرِفَ, until the Imam leaves, كُتِبَ لَهُ قِيَامُ لَيْلِ, it will be written for him the prayer of the whole night. You will get the reward of praying that whole night. What is meant by until the Imam leaves? It means until the salah is finished. That's what it means. It doesn't mean as if the imam leaves. Because we have in our countries that there are more than one imam who lead the prayer. So somebody would pray four rak'ah with the first imam and he would go home. And he would try to apply this hadith to himself. He would say, مَنْ قَامَ مَعَ الْإِمَامِ حَتَّى يَنْصَرِفْ كُتِبَ لَهُ قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ. He said, I prayed with the imam until the imam left, so I have a prayer of the whole night. But in reality, he hasn't prayed the other four rak'ah, and he also hasn't prayed the witr. So the hadith is not talking about the imam himself, rather it is talking about انقضاء الصلاة, the ending of the prayer. Anyone who starts the prayer with the imam, and he finishes the prayer, that's what the hadith is referring to. And the qiyam and the prayer, my brothers, the taraweeh is only nights, 29 nights of the whole year. هي إلا ليال معدودة يغتنمها العاقل قبل فواتها. There are only specific nights in your life, 29 nights only, which you can benefit from. The wise person doesn't let it go by like that. Abu Dawood, he has a masail, he has a book where he asked Imam Ahmed questions. It's called Masail al-Imam Ahmed li Abi Dawood al-Sijistani, the author of the Sunan. Abu Dawood, he has a book in which he asks Imam Ahmed questions. Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal, he asks him questions. He said in that book of his, page 62, so only one volume book. He said, قيل لأحمد وأنا أسمع. Abu Dawood said, Imam Ahmed was asked, and he said, I was listening while he was asked this question. يؤخر القيام. Does one delay the prayer إلى آخر الليل, until the last part of the night? Is that good for one to do? يعني تراويح. Imam Ahmed said, لا, no. سنة المسلمين أحب إليها. The way that the people are, the sunnah of the people is more beloved to me. If a person shouldn't pray by himself, he should try to pray with the imam because of that virtue. This is what Imam Ahmed's qawl is saying. That for you to say, I'm going to delay my prayer and pray by myself at home and do my thing, Imam Ahmed said that the sunnah of being with the people is more beloved to me. The scholars, they differed. If the person رغب الإنسان أن يصلي ما كتب له وقت السحر. He wants to pray at night time. After the Taraweeh, he wants to pray. He prays with the Imam. What should he do in this situation? The scholars, they differ in this matter. Some of the scholars, they said, فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُؤْتَرُ فِي آخِرِ صَلَاتِ مَرَّةٍ أُخْرَى. He does not Before I go into that, he should not pray the witr with the Imam. Some scholars, they said, with the imam, he should not pray the witr. He should what? He should pray the 8 rak'ah and the extra 2 and the last rak'ah, he should leave it and not pray it. 10 rak'ah basically. Because the witr should be the last thing that the person does. Some scholars, they took that opinion. And others, and they based that on the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, لا وتران في ليلة There is no two witr at night time. لا وترانِ في ليلة. There is no two witrs in one night. So they said in that situation, what he does is, that he doesn't pray the witr with the first imam, he goes and he prays the witr with his last rak'ah. But Sheikh Nasiruddin al-Albani, rahimahullah, he said no, he is allowed to pray after the witr. He's allowed to pray again and carry on praying. He's allowed to pray, but he is not going to pray witr after his prayer. But that may oppose the hadith of Prophet ﷺ, in which he said, اِجْعَلُوا آخِرَ صَلَاتِكُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وِتْرًا. Make the last prayer, the last thing that you do for your night, make it the witr. So the command here is not عَلَى الْوُجُوبِ, it is عَلَى الْنَدْبِ. Highly recommended that he makes it. But Sheikh Nasir's opinion is much stronger, because these ahadith, he said all of them, they show that it's nadb, that it's recommended, and that is not obligatory. Because the evidence that he brought was hadith Ibn Khuzaymah narrated in his sahih, bi sanadin sahih, with a chain of narration which is authentic, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Prophet ﷺ prayed after his witr. Another prayer. When the person, they do their tasreem, assalamu alaikum, assalamu alaikum, and they finish their prayer, in the last, the salatul witr, finished. They finished their taraweeh, the witr, the last one. The person should raise their voice by saying, Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, three times. And he raises his voice in the third time. The third time he raises his voice. Because that was authentically transmitted from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Imam Abu Dawood narrated in his Sunan, An-Nasa'i ibn Majah Ahmed, and the hadith is authentic. Daraqutni, he added an extra part. He said, he says, Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, Rabbu al-Malaikati wal-Ruh. He added that ziyada to it. But that ziyada is shad. It is shad. It's a ziyada ghayra mahfuzah. And you would find that if you look at the takhrij al-hadith al-dhikr wal-du'a al-Qahtani, the tahqiq, which Yasir Ibn Fathi al-Misri put on it. Because he recently, a takhrij in which he done on the Kitab Sunan Abi Dawood is also out. So he speaks about it there, and we will stop there inshallah ta'ala. Wallahu a'lam. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.